four-game regular season set between longtime Central Division rivals St. Louis and Chicago.
Big faceoff win right there by Kirby Dach, number 77, and yet they still had St. Louis Blues were all over them. Mackenzie McEachern kept the puck in.
And we've got action here on the near boards. Everybody involved in this.
Heat is rising. It's not surprising between these two teams. We've talked to some of them about the rivalry, and it's not just hockey. It's their baseball teams. It's their cities. It goes deep. And of course, these teams right now, they're battling throughout the league, and it's a physical game. We talked about it. Not surprised, and here it is.
And it's not done yet.
Getting hotter.
Our officials thought they had broken things up, but the fans say, I don't think so.
Kajula and Dunn, that is a heavyweight.
And now Kajula and Dunn going at it. Drake Kajula. Got some old-time hockey here, AJ.
Vince Dunn is the smallest defenseman they have in the lineup, but he is fighting like a big guy right now.
And Dunn, happy with his performance as Kajula gets down to the ice, and the fans loving every minute of this here tonight at the United Center.
Kajula slow to get up.
Listen to this crowd.
Appreciation on the bench. Fights like that certainly invigorate the crowd. We can hear it, but there's Kajula getting everybody fired up. You can see the teammates, the appreciation they have for their teammates in the line of fire.
And Drake Kajula he's doing what he did from the drop of the puck.
Here's a big hit that comes in here. It's Sundqvist that takes down it. This was Boqvist coming across, and he stayed down for a little bit. It's Sundqvist sort of misses him, but his arm grabs him, comes around, and Boqvist stayed down a little bit, and then the Heat was up a little further in the neutral zone. You can see his stick clotheslines him a little bit.
So Sundqvist, inadvertent or not, right to the face, and then Kajula and Dunn going at it.
Well, Kajula, you were talking about some other players that want to bring Sealer wanting to bring sandpaper. That's exactly what Kajula does bring to this lineup. He's gritty. He gets to the front of the net. He really works hard. And here we're seeing an extra gritty side of him.
Well, and saw a little bit of that this morning when we had some fun with Drake in the dressing room, right?
We did. We talked the whole line, and there's a lightness about them. They were joking with us. They were having fun, and we were standing in the way of his stall, and he was teasing us that he had to get through and sit down.
Led the University of North Dakota to that 2016 NC2A title, did Drake Kajula. Named the most outstanding player of the Frozen Four. Wore the number 9 that was previously worn by Jonathan Taves at UND. And now the two both still have a 9 on their sweaters. My goodness, Kajula got the brunt of that one from Dunn.
See, it looks like a necklace. A chain came flying off, too. And Kajula knowing what this can do, and he's firing up his teammates and firing up the crowd, and it worked.
There was a major penalty assessed on the play and will now be reviewed.
Got a review on the play.
And Kate and AJ, I am still down here. There's just a lot of chatter between the
benches. Snuck in against the far post. Daylock thought about playing it, eventually covers it, and Kovalchuk getting into it with Hartman, and Kovalchuk is incensed.
We got a few things going on here. Mikko quite Lucerne on the Minnesota bench. And Hartman's involved with Brendan Dillon right now. Dillon's got size on Hartman, and Dillon knows how to go, and they're gonna go.
So Dillon pulls Hartman out of the pile. They square up just inside the zone. Hartman snuck a left in there. Looked like he stunned Dillon a little bit, but lost his balance. And Hartman swinging lefts, Dillon swinging rights. Dillon caught him with an uppercut. As Hartman ducked out of the way of a hit. And then Dillon starts going to the uppercuts again.
Oh, Hartman just switched on him now, went righty, and he's got him.
What a tilt.
Yeah. Two guys that understand their roles.
And Hartman gonna fire up the crowd here in St. Paul.
Koivu is not feeling very well. You can see him on the bench. Stalock's going to freeze the puck. Kovalchuk didn't like getting pushed by Hartman, so he's incensed. Ovechkin comes in. Dumba's down. Stahl jumps in. Carlson comes in. and Dylan's right there with Hartman. And you can see, okay, I'll go, you go, and then they go. Hartman starts by going left. Eventually, he's going to switch to his right. Spirited battle right there, Brendan.
Brendan Dillon, 6'4". Ryan Hartman giving up 4 inches on that fight. So they just announced the penalties here, and Kovalchuk's been given 4 minutes for roughing.
And, of course, tickets to the game. How about coming from Calgary to L.A.?
Oh, here we go.
To see a little bit of this. With Lucic and McDermott, a heavyweight scrap. Round two between these two. McDermott unable to get himself any sort of leverage. Lucic with a couple of rights. McDermott countering. Helmet comes off for Lucic. McDermott's bucket stays on. Lucic going after McDermott and throws him down for good measure. But a well-earned stick tap from both benches.
Now that is one way to get both benches up and energized. And I'm telling you, Alex, as soon as that puck was dropped and the gloves came off, little chat beforehand, of course, right in the middle. See Lucic? There's the challenge. I think you see Milan Lucic there nod his head. Yep, I'm ready to go. And there go the gloves and the stick of Lucic, and it was on. Two big boys, and they weren't playing a lot of defense either, by the way. They were just throwing bombs.
And McDermott, after grappling a little bit, unable to get free, and then landed a couple really powerful rights. And you saw the damage done to Lucic.
Fanned on it, it went right to slot, and the Senators buried it. And it's kind of the same thing. DeBrincat just fans on it. It's not like it's the wrong play he's making. It's just the wrong timing of it.
And we are going to have a fight, and it's going to be Nick Seeler against Nathan Beaulieu. We've talked about Seeler. Beaulieu recently back into the lineup. Starts with the rights, and they are chucking them back and forth.
Sean Reynolds showed in the opening all the scrappiness of the Winnipeg Jets, and they have done a great job over the last little while of letting each other know that they're there for one another. And this is a real good tell. The little mouse under the eye, he cut him on the cheekbone, and he's going to have to go get repaired here for sure. That's a good open cut there. Seeler is a tough customer, and we said that at the beginning, and this obviously is something they had talked about. He didn't like the way maybe he was taking it on Ehlers in front of the net. And Beaulieu is no wallflower here. He's a tough kid as well, and he stands right in there with a tough customer in Seeler. And 55 and 88, no protection, just throw. Throw and throw and throw. I'm not quite sure where Seeler caught him. I think it might have been early. And he's winding up his bench. And a real good scrap. And the crowd's loving it.
Crowd loves Fantenberg it. Drops to Horvat for a shot. Saved by Stalock. Again, we get some barking and the gloves are off again. McEwen, this time with Foligno. Right on the button. Oh, boy. Whoa. Two or three of those punches that Marcus Foligno threw there landed right on the button. Obviously the McEwen kid. He had 13 minutes in penalties coming into tonight. He has 7 in this game and the crowd loves it. Fighting majors against McEwen and Foligno, and this was a heavyweight.
It certainly was, and McEwen is a guy who's trying to make a name for himself. Marcus Foligno, that punch right there, I thought hit him right on the button. He was very fortunate that that one did not connect. These two guys were throwing absolute haymakers. A nice block right there, and this one here does connect right on the button. That one would have put me to sleep for a while right there, Anthony. But you know, this kid, you got to give him some credit. He's a rookie trying to...